Hey gents, today we're going to look at all of the chinos. We're looking at almost 20 different brands, from the $29 H&M chinos to $150 Ascot chinos and everything in between. I'll also link to a blog post that's actually done this time that has more information on material composition, sizing availability, colors, and everything else. This video is already gonna be long, so I'm gonna put tech chinos and custom chinos in a different video, but chinos are my number one go-to pant. They can be dressed up, they can be dressed down, and if you're looking to upgrade your current wardrobe or diversify your trouser selection from denim, this is going to be a great video. And so my evaluation criteria is basically, number one, quality. I'm looking for fabric, construction, and comfort. I'm also looking for price to value ratio. I rarely find that the cheapest thing is the best. There's a very big difference between overpriced and expensive. I'm also looking at size availability and then colors and styles available. You'll see in this video, some of the chinos are a little bit short on me. I couldn't always get a 34 inseam, which is what I need. A 31, 34 is basically my perfect size in most of these brands. I'm 6'4 and 180 to give you an idea of what you're seeing in the clothing and the sizing. And my overarching goal of this channel is to get you to spend a little bit more money on less clothing so you can get higher quality stuff that lasts longer and makes you feel good for a longer period of time. All the opinions in this video come from me owning, wearing, and washing each of the chinos, trying to get you the best information possible. So thank you for subscribing and giving a thumbs up. In the categories that we're gonna look at today, I'm gonna give you the best overall option. So for most guys, what is the best chino you can get? I'm also gonna do the best budget option. I'm gonna give you the most luxurious option. And then I'll also have some honorable mentions. I will put timestamps because I will talk about all 20 brands individually. So I'll put timestamps and links below so you can check out all the stuff. Some of those are affiliate links, supports the channel, gets you more videos like this. And before we get into the chinos, I'll give you a quick history on the chino itself. The origin of chinos dates back to the mid-19th century with the creation of the khaki color in India by a British military officer. At the time, they wore white and he dyed them with tea, sand, dirt to try and get something that was a little more appropriate for their climate. And then in the Spanish-American War, they started producing lightweight twill in China, and the word chino comes from the Spanish slang for China. The rise of Gap Inc. in the 70s and 80s strongly correlates with the rise in chinos because this was a hugely popular style for them and they really brought it to the masses. Today, chinos are differentiated from khakis mostly by their stitching. Khakis are a little bit less formal, they have exposed stitching, and they're usually a heavier weight. Chinos are slimmer, usually with a modern cut, and of course, a lot more colors. The soft cotton twill of chinos makes them the perfect trousers for business casual attire, from suit separates with dress shoes to Oxford cotton button-downs and white sneakers, as you'll see today. So there's your mini history lesson on chinos. And just one last note before we get in, a lot of the prices are based on the MSRP. I know there's a lot of different things you can do with sales and combos and that kind of stuff, but I'm just going based off of MSRP. And then the sizing availability is what's available as I'm doing this video. Things change all the time, but I will update the blog accordingly. So let's get into it. So if you're looking for the best chino for most guys with a wide range of size, style, and color availability and the best fits, you're going to be looking for either Bonobos or for Banana Republic. And let's talk about each of them. Bonobos wins for several reasons. This is their wash chino at $88. This pair right here is about 6 years old, has been washed many times. And the reason that Bonobos has become such a staple in my wardrobe is not only do they almost always have my size available, 31, 34. This is actually a 30, 34 back when, before I was hitting the gym and running as much. But they have this curved waistband, which gives you a very good fit, especially, you know, I've tried all these chinos. Bonobos has the best feeling chinos out there. And the fabric itself is extremely durable, so it holds up to many different washes. And they also have a wide range of styles, from tailored, slim, athletic, straight, and then you can almost always find your combination of waist and length size, which is going to get you that perfect near custom fit, and at only $88. They do also offer some tech chinos, some Oxford chinos. They have a premium line as well, but the standard Bonobos wash chino is going to be the best bet. And if you're anything like me, the first time I put these chinos on, it literally changed my life. The second option is going to be Banana Republic. These chinos also come in at that $90 price point. You can usually get some sort of sales within there, but the combination of premium twill, a great design, especially around the waistband, and then a wide range of size and color availability is going to tick the boxes for most of you guys. And Banana Republic also offers free alterations in store if you have one of their credit cards. And so if you go to one of their stores, you can also get the perfect fit based on there. And so that is a great resounding reason to go with high quality stuff. Next, we have our best budget option, and it's going to be two different ones. It's either going to be Jomers, which I was super impressed with. These ones come in at $58. $29. They have some slightly lower priced ones out there. Or you're gonna go to Uniqlo. Big surprise. I did include budget ones in here. So this is the Amazon GoodThreads brand, which come in at $35. But the way that the waistband is constructed, the way that the fabric feels, and you know, there is a little bit of stretch in here, that I just am not crazy about the design of these, especially when for nearly the same price, you can go to Uniqlo and get a little bit more streamlined of a design. The fabric on this feels slightly better. You also get a wider range of styles available. Amazon GoodThreads has tons of sizes, so that is one of the bonus points of those, but I've never been crazy about the design. And for Jomers, this is their Italian moleskin chino. And I think that for $58, if you're looking to go for like your first really nice chino, step outside of the H&Ms and some of the lower end brands, and you don't quite wanna go to Bonobos at $88, I think that Jomers is a really nice in between here. And I've been really impressed with these. They have slim and straight availability. They also have plenty of waist and length sizes. They don't have as many colors available, which I think they're gonna be changing that soon with their new collection. But Jomers overall, I've been very impressed with these, and I'm gonna do some follow-up videos on more of their items because I think they're offering some really good value for the prices they're coming in at. So those are your budget options. If you wanna go to the other side of the spectrum, we're looking at the most luxurious and some of my favorites. We have Leadbury and Ascot. This is my first brush with Ascot's stuff, and I'm really happy that I included these in the roundup. The premium Italian twill on these holds up really well to washing and multiple wears. I love the two clasp design of the waistband, super clean silhouette, nice slim taper through the pant, and then also a nice wide range of sizes. Leadbury comes in with the Richmond pant, and from the way that the padded multi-reinforced waistband, the after dinner split for extra room and comfort, and the really premium feeling twill, there's a reason that these come in at $145, but these have been heavy in my rotation since they came in back in the fall. Both of these brands are great examples of having premium product with really high quality raw materials combined with great construction to give you a really excellent pant. So if you have the budget for it and you're looking for great pants, look no further than Ascot and Leadbury. Before we get into all of the brands, I wanna give some honorable mentions as well. Woody's, I believe at $98, is one of the best values because it is custom. So here, I have a pretty slim silhouette on these, but you customize it entirely based on your measurement. So not only will you get the perfect waist and the perfect length, but if you want more of a straight fit, they'll make it a little bit more loose for you. If you want this type of slimmer fit, they can also do that. And they have a fit guarantee. So if you're a little hesitant about going for custom, Woody's has one of the best guarantees out there for making sure you get the exact right fit. Also, a few weeks ago, I unboxed their flannel line chinos and they basically haven't left my body. They've been one of the best pickups so far, especially because it's been pretty cold this winter. Next honorable mention goes out to Peter Manning. If you're on the shorter side and you have never purchased pants that truly fit, Peter Manning might be the first brand that you can. They offer inseams 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30, and they have tons of waist sizes available as well. So if you're on the shorter side and you're not shopping Peter Manning, you should. And if you're not watching The Modest Man, you should too. Jumping to the opposite end of the spectrum again, we're going to look at American Tall. American Tall offers huge inseams. I believe I saw 38s on there, and they also have a good combination of waist sizes as well, and they have a great feeling product, and it comes in at a very reasonable price. So if you're on the taller side, I did a whole video on American Tall, especially if you're above 6'4", 6'5", then they really cater to us tall guys. Scotch and Soda. This brand can be a little bit hit or miss because they can be pretty fashion forward. They definitely have very European, very slim fits, but I've had this pair of chinos. I believe it came in a Stitch Fix box a couple years ago, and at a 31, 34, it's the perfect fit. Premium fabrics, they do carry a premium price range of $125, but they give you that back in quality fabrics, great construction, and even though these have been washed about a dozen times, they still look great. Same thing with the Leadbury. Like if you invest in premium fabrics, premium quality, they last longer, which is what I'm trying to get you to do. And the last honorable mention goes to Spoke, which I did a whole unboxing video on them recently in each of their lines. I really like the Heroes. If I could just pick any chino, price wasn't a factor, it would either be Bonobos or Spoke. You know, I really like what Spoke is doing. I like their design. They have a really premium fabric. I like their wide range of sizes that are available. That's a huge plus for me. Same thing with the colors that are available. And I just really like the brand aesthetic overall. They have a great customer experience as well. And so Spoke is definitely somebody to keep an eye on. So those are the categories I wanted to present. Now I'll get into each of the individual brands. I also want to say at the top that there are stores you can shop which will give you either free or reduced alterations. One of those being Nordstrom. You can also go to Uniqlo. Lands' End offers in-store tailoring, J. Crew, and then Banana Republic, as I mentioned, with the card members. And so if you do have the struggle of buying pants that fit really well, you don't have a tailor that you normally go to, there are stores out there that will include alteration services. Check the details on some of those. I know Uniqlo has like a price threshold you need to spend. Same thing, Nordstrom, you can't get suiting done. But it's worth finding out if you can get your alterations done in the store you purchased from. So let's get into each brand individually, and I'd love to hear from you down below on your experiences as well. So GoodThreads, there's definitely some stretch in the chinos, but the design has always left a lot to be desired. I feel like it's a very cheap looking design, and my wife called that out the very first time. She could just tell that they were like a budget chino. I'm not crazy about the way that the pockets are designed. I'm not crazy about the fly or button clasp. And although these are only $35, I think you can do better at that price point. And when it comes to the design, the cuff of the GoodThreads always bothered me. It's really tall especially compared to something like the Bonobo Swash Chino or the Ascot Chinos. I think those shorter ones are a little bit more elegant than the GoodThreads, but also just the way that it's stitched and the way that it looks, I think really illustrates the difference between a cheap chino and a premium chino. I'm also mixed on the design of the fly. Some of the pants use a two-button design, but sometimes a second button closes the fly and it makes it difficult for access for using the bathroom. And because I drink 4 liters of water a day, I'm constantly peeing, so it becomes a huge inconvenience. Bonobos, I think I talked about them enough. The gray pair in this video is at least 6 years old. I have pairs from multiple seasons. I have pairs that are very old, that have been worn a lot. I did blow out one of them in the crotch, but that was because I wore it way too much and it was a little bit small. But Bonobos, highly, highly recommended, as I said, in the best overall. Jomers, like I talked about, one of the most surprising ones of this roundup. It was the first time I really checked them out, but I've been very impressed with the fabrics. This is one of the higher priced items. They have like some $50 jeans that look very nice. I actually have a pair here that I'm gonna be trying on. And so Jomers was one of the best surprises of this roundup. The J. Crew ones are the 484s, and you can definitely see why they're still a venerable brand in this category, but I couldn't really find a good place for them in the rest of this roundup. I think that the fabric is okay. I think it feels decent. I know you can get them on discount if there's certain sales going on, but the full price on these, I just don't think is worth it. And even some of their broken in chinos and the vintage cuts and everything, I think they're nice, but these other brands are doing it better now. With the Express chinos, feeling the fabric, they feel cheaper than the Amazon GoodThreads. They feel cheaper than the H&M ones. I think these are a huge ripoff at $59. When I was trying to buy the pair, they were also offering a second pair for $39, which would have made both of the pairs like $50 or something. But the Express ones, super disappointing. Actually, not entirely, because Express clothes falling apart is the reason I started my channel in the first place. In my opinion, most mall brands are overpriced products, and you're getting way better value with these other brands, and that's what you're seeing here 100%. So the Uniqlo ones, I actually have two pairs, and as I mentioned in my budget picks, between the quality of the fabric, the design, and you know overall that ratio of price to quality, I think Uniqlo is very tough to beat. You can definitely feel that 3% stretch in here, and I like the way that the fly is designed, the side pockets, and overall Uniqlo coming through again, great value for money. Ledbury, as I mentioned in my best luxurious picks, the twill fabric of this feels so good, and I love the way that the waistband is designed, the reinforced and slightly padded stitching around the waistband. I like the fly design and the way that the buttonholes are reinforced. Also that dinner split, or I think they call it the after dinner split in the back, which gives you just that much more tiny bit of comfort. But overall, you mean, these are a $145 chino, but you can feel every penny of it and the quality of the fabric and the way that this chino is put together. So I really like this one. This was my first brush with Ascot, and I'm really glad I ended up including them in this roundup. The Italian cotton twill feels so good, and they brought together a really unique two clasp design. So they have a slide clasp on the inside and then a button with the offset button, and then the zipper itself is a really sturdy YKK. The Uniqlo ones have a very flimsy YKK, which I wasn't crazy about, but this is the reason that you have this premium chino from Ascot. I also love the way that the waistband is designed, and I like the pocket design, which is similar to the Bonobos one. It's just a clean slit from Tailor Stitch. This was my first brush with any of their bottoms. I have one of their shirts that I really like back when they were all made in the USA. The chinos, not made in the USA. This is the Organic Ash Slim Chino, and I'm pretty disappointed in this. $98, you know, you can do way better at $98 than these Tailor Stitch ones. I'm not crazy about the way that the fabric feels, especially around the waistband. I think a huge giveaway for a lot of chinos is the way that it feels when I'm trying to button them. You can just feel in the fabric quality. You know, it's pretty good, but then again, if I'm paying $98, you know, I have higher expectations for chinos at that price, and all of their inseams are 36 inches, which is great because I can get something that'll fit me, but that pretty much means an automatic trip to the tailor, so you're looking at another $10, $20 for alterations on the inseam, and so Tailor Stitch chinos, $98, you know, I would pass on these. Buck Mason definitely has a great feel to the fabric. The weight of the chino really calls in that $135 price point. The design of the waistband with this reinforced stitching and these two little side handles, you can see all these little details that really work out to there. Unfortunately, they have one standard inseam, but this one did end up fitting on me. Some guys will probably have to have that redone. But you can also see around the waistband that it has a more premium look, especially when compared to that Amazon Good Threads. It also has the rear pocket design that I prefer. Even though there is a little bit longer of a rise than I prefer, these definitely warrant the premium that they're asking, and when comparing like Buck Mason to Tailor Stitch, I pick the Buck Mason's one every time. The H&M chinos, I had to go pick these up because I didn't have a current pair in my rotation, but H&M were the first chinos I ever purchased, but they deteriorated as H&M and Zara quality clothing does after a few washes. They also had the problem, especially in the store, it was really tough to get my size. Now they do have a premium offering, but it's only available online. I would like to order that and compare what you're getting between the two of these, but even though these are the cheapest ones in the bunch, you know, if you step up just a little bit to Uniqlo, you're doing a lot better for the design, quality, and construction at a nearly similar price. And what I'd really encourage is to go up, I think, what, $15 or $20 to go into the Jomers stuff, because it's much better quality of fabric, wider range of size availability and colors, and you know, that's where I think these big companies like H&M are being outdone by a nice small guy like Jomers. You know, I always notice on the back of guys' pants when they have the little Banana Republic tag right above the pocket, and I really like the design of the fly on this one. It's just a clean, simple one. Hidden button, there is a second button on the inside, very sturdy zipper, says Banana Republic, and the twill cotton feels very good on this. It's a 100% cotton twill, so there is no stretch in there, but it does have some give to it, as cotton does. They have plenty of sizes available online, and if you do some, you know, financial engineering with their sales and everything, you get these on a really good discount. And so Banana Republic, I'm happy to say that an incumbent like this, similar to, you know, similar to J. Crew, but I think that they really still have that gold standard for a great chino. ASOS, you know, reminds me a lot of H&M. I actually had trouble finding like the ASOS brand when I was searching ASOS.com, but it's, you know, it's a cheap chino. It's made to be a certain price point. I'm not crazy about the way that the fabric looks. You know, it feels like it's gonna fall apart after a couple of washes, and there's even a color transfer disclaimer on the tag, which none of the other chinos do, and so that's what you get what you pay for. Tailored, I did a whole video on them if you want to check that out, but you know, I think the fit is okay. It's 31-34, slightly shorter than my other 34 inch inseams, but the fabric on here I just am not crazy about. I think for $75 you can do better, but I do like some of the other design aspects. I like that the pocket liner is decorated. They're trying to set themselves apart a little bit by having the pant cuff on the bottom. When you roll it, it is the accent of the inner lining. The twill is pretty soft, but you can tell after a couple of washes, it'll be right in there with like the Good Threads and J. Crew, you know, slightly lower end twills. With the Gap chinos, it really illustrates the difference. Because Gap owns Banana Republic, they don't have too much overlap in their offerings. The Gap chinos are a little bit more casual. You know, the stitching and design on these aren't quite as good for like buttoned up business casual as a Banana Republic ones. The chino, the twill feels okay. I was able to get a slim 32-34, but with these retailing at $60, I'd much rather go with the Jomers or the Uniqlo over the Gap. I just threw these ones in for fun. Untuck It chinos. They are actually no longer offered on the website, but you know, as I talked about in my previous video, I think these were $145. You can feel that the twill is very nice. I couldn't really get my size, so they're a little bit big on me. I usually wear these as like beater chinos around the house. And not much more to say about these ones because you can't even buy them anymore. So there you have it, gents. That is my not totally absurd chino collection, but I've slowly collected these over the years as you guys have recommended brands and recommended products, and I really wanted to just give them the proper time to do this. I'm working on several other roundups similar to this year, and I'm really looking forward to you joining me and trying to find the best menswear on the internet. As I mentioned in the Express video, when I started my first corporate job, I bought tons of stuff from Express. I spent a ton of money there, and then in like 6 months it deteriorated. And that's what really opened my eyes to getting better quality stuff, spending a little bit more on less items, being a little bit less fashion forward, and trying to have more of the staple wardrobe. And I'm really excited to cover that stuff this year, and I hope you will join me. So share this video with anybody you know shopping for great chinos. Just send them the link, and I really appreciate you helping me in this channel. And as always, I love your comments, feedback. I'm also at @_Cavalier on Twitter and Instagram. Until next time, gents, this is The Cavalier. Who can take a sunrise, sprinkle it with chinos, cover it in chocolate and a miracle or two? The Candyman, Willy Wonka can.